Mercury might contain tons of diamonds. Wow! But firstly, Mercury is one of the most boring planets in the solar system. However, this is not Mercury's fault, but mainly because humans know so little about this tiny planet. Although compared to the gas giants billions of kilometers away from here, Mercury is relatively close to the Earth. But because it is a little bit too close to the Sun, observing planet Mercury on Earth is not a very good idea. For most of the details on this world, we can only rely on space probes, like the ones we sent to Mars. Anyway, when you first see the appearance of Mercury, you'll think it's strikingly similar to the Moon. I mean, look at that, same gray appearance, tons of impact craters. But after the Messenger space probe wandered around on Mercury and gathered some more information, that information revealed that there is a lot of carbon on the surface of Mercury, and we all know that carbon comes in many forms, and the carbon on the surface of Mercury is mainly in the form of graphite, your pencil. But the question is, why? Why is this substance present in large quantities? Most likely scenario, the surface of Mercury was an ocean of molten rock early in the formation of the solar system. In turn, Mercury formed at a location where temperatures were high enough that lighter elements would not have gathered in large quantities, making the carbon content of these lavas relatively large. As the planet cooled, the surface magma solidified, and this carbon was converted to stable graphite. Of course, there is a less likely scenario. A group of aliens visited the solar system in the time of ancient Egypt, and those aliens loved pencils and stocked billions of pencil leads in their spaceship. Unfortunately, the spaceship exploded when approaching planet Mercury and the blast shattered all these pencil leads and caused them scattered across the surface of Mercury. Anyway, regardless of the surface, the inner part of Mercury is also very carbon-rich. Although Mercury is a tiny planet, it still has very high temperatures in its core. In the interior of a planet at high temperatures and pressures, what would that carbon become? You may know that Mercury has a large core, but I'm telling you that it is not large, but extremely large. So large, that if you dig straight into Mercury, just at 16% of the planet's radius you would reach the core region. If you do the same on Earth, you would have to go much deeper, into 46% of the radius. In the early days of Mercury, the interior part is very energetic. The region where the mantle meets the core, the pressure is basically no different from burying yourself on a white dwarf. In this extreme state, carbon will tend to form one of the most stable forms of matter, which is diamond. As Mercury's core cooled over hundreds of millions of years, it gradually evolved from liquid to solid from the outside in, and all the diamonds inside slowly crystallized, upwelling to the mantle boundary beyond the liquid core. Meanwhile, in the early magma oceans, remember that Mercury's surface was also rich in carbon? It's also possible that diamonds formed at greater depths, just like on Earth. These diamonds settled to the bottom of the early magma oceans, and eventually also rested at the boundary between the mantle and the Mercury's core. And so, with an operation by magical nature, today's Mercury, if you dig down 400 kilometers to the boundary zone between the mantle and the core, there's a pretty good chance you'll come across a diamond ore zone that's 20 kilometers deep. However, you gotta be careful because even after 4.5 billion years, the temperature there is still way above 1,000 degrees. Let's just assume that 5% of the layer's mass is contributed by the diamonds. That would be 175 quintillion kilograms. Or 875 sextillion carats. But those diamonds are just raw diamonds and most of them are probably not very pretty. The price is not going to exceed a few hundred US dollars per carats. But still, this generates around 400 septillion dollars. But at that point diamonds are just a common useless material. Maybe some Lon's delight? So you see, no planet is a boring planet. Let's just give Mercury some tiny love. By the way, JWST is finding new so-called habitable planets? Well, watch this video and you will have a clearer understanding of what is a true habitable planet.